As more and more town folk started to lose their minds, Channel 2000 News started covering the catastrophe.
My body is an illusion. The bones are an illusion. That is, it needs to be. Therefore, the Indian transcendence is an illusion. Therefore, the earth proved an illusion. My mighty Yu-King, the king of ages and reader of Diana's bar of perfection and choice. Indeed, a worthy man. To see no kingdom would surely curse. Surely she is one, then, and my people, the good, are all one. And all that which is not good in her creation anyway, and therefore, in the sight of supreme good, good. And then it isn't not saved, doesn't burn, isn't good that way. I don't take up his faith. Perhaps in prison. In prison. I don't take up his faith. I don't take up no Bill Clinton's, man. I don't take up no prison music, huh? Is it on crime? What?
My brother escaped from the loony bin and started making a home movie on the madness.
Hi. How are you today? There you go. Why don't you reach in and pick a chicken? There you go.
That's right.
Yeah, pick a chicken. No, don't be shy. Come on now. Come back over here. Yeah, it's okay. What I want you to do is reach in and pick a chicken. It's in the back of the cage, if that helps. There you go. What? No! Don't be shy, as I said! Come. Pick a chicken. Yeah, right here. To the back, yeah, it's in the back of the cage. There you go. Yeah, it's in the back of the cage. There you have it. That's it. It's in the back of the cage. The chicken is in the back of the cage.
Thank you.
Yes, they are. Do you understand? I'm not Reginald McCartney. I'm the Pineapple Man. Pineapples go good with cold cottage cheese. But what's even better is a pineapple sneeze.
Channel 2000 was now showing nothing but 24-hour news coverage of the Schoof epidemic, no matter how outrageous or obscene. This was the catastrophe of the century, and they wanted it taped constantly so they would have plenty to play with in editing when they started cutting together a DVD of the highlights that they planned to rush out in time for the upcoming holidays. But their decision to air the coverage uncensored came with plenty of backlash. Bible belters and other conservative creatures were really up in arms over the following footage. Personally, I don't have a problem with it. It's just a human in some plastic. But man, did that bunch throw a shit fit. The channel's inbox was flooded with enraged emails and the paper printed letters from the livid. Here's one from my scrapbook. Dear Channel 2000, how dare you air this pornographic garbage? I know our town is going through a hell of a crisis right now, but there's no need to televise the terror's trashy moments. My 7-year-old son was sitting in with me and my husband's news viewing last night when this smutty scum popped up and polluted our home. My child started crying and my husband fainted. I couldn't find the remote and my weight problem keeps me couch-ridden, so I could not shut off the sick sight on the screen. My boy kept screaming, "No, Mommy, no, make it stop," but I couldn't, and I know what you're thinking. Why didn't you just have your son turn the tube off by hand? Well, I'll have you know that my son was born without limbs, so we were stuck in the muck of your unforgivable broadcast, and you're gonna pay for it. I told my child, "Close your eyes, Chad," but he couldn't, because he has a room full of dolls like the one that guy was orally abusing on air, and Chad pretends his dolls are playing hopscotch. His room has a concrete floor, no carpet, no nothing, just plain concrete like a sidewalk, and there's hopscotch squares drawn on it with charcoal. So you can imagine what the sick sight you showed has done to his world. He will never be the same again, and we're gonna sue you scumbags for every cent you got. Chad hawked loogies on his dolls this morning and kept screaming, "Dolls are whores!" My husband was at the calculator plant, so there was nobody to go in and comfort him. I just listened from the couch in absolute horror, crying my eyes out and asking God why channels like yours exist. You have ruined our lives and we must be compensated. I'm having the living room wall knocked down so that I can be helicoptered to the courtroom to see the look on your faces when you hear how much the judge orders you to pay us. Have a wonderful day, and I hope Schoof makes you self-mutilate your private parts. Debbie Papagonia. P.S. Television is a precious thing. It provides many happy hours for the good people of this planet, and you have puked on its importantness. Our family will never watch it again, and that's pretty sad because I'm sure there will be millions of others shutting off their sets for good as well, and I wonder what kind of a world we'll have soon. A worthless one, I reckon.
I hope I didn't name you wrong.
If tolerance is the word, then stamina would be its classier replacement.
Yay! I did something right for a change.
Shoo! What is the next step if I can't move forward?
Death! 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 Death!
Again, we don't want no strange monster around. We just want to bake some cookies. So please get out of here. This is the last time I'll say it. We are at the end of our rope. I don't want to have to hurt you, but I will if I have to, cause you're fucking up our groove. Again.